The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Dear children, already 6 months have passed due to present COVID-19 pandemic situations that we have met. As you know that we were in school, we usually start the day with meditation, right? Meditation energizes your body, mind and intellect. It also keeps the mind steady like a candid flame in a sheltered place. If you do meditation regularly, definitely you can feel super change will happen in your whole body. So children, do it regularly as daily basis at home also. Find time for it. Okay, my dear children? Now, let us pass on to our new topic, One Side and Two Angles. If all the sides of a triangle are given, we can draw the triangle. If two sides and the angle made by them are given, then also we can draw the triangle, right? What if the one side and angles on its ends are given? For example, the length of a side is 8 cm. And angles at its ends are 40 degree and 60 degree. Can you draw the triangle? Yes. It can be drawn like this. Base 8 cm. Angles are 40 degree and 60 degree. Next. Base 8 cm. Changing the positions of the angles, 60 degree and 40 degree. Any other way? It can be drawn like this. Children, see these two triangles. These triangles, one side and two angles on its ends are equal, right? These triangles, place them one over the other. What did you see now? Here, this side and these angles are equal, right? You can see that the other two sides are also equal, right? What about this angle? This angle is also equal. Right, children? From this, we have a third general principle. If one side of a triangle and the angles at its ends are equal to one side of another triangle and the angles at its ends, then the third angles are also equal and the sides opposite equal angles are equal. Is it clear, children? Children, see these triangles. In triangle ABC, AB is 8 cm, angle A is 40 degree and angle B is 60 degree. In triangle PQR, PQ is 8 cm, angle P is 40 degree and angle Q is 80 degree. Right? What is the third angle of each triangle? We know that in any triangle, the sum of all three angles is 180 degree. Right? That is, in triangle ABC, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Here, 40 plus 60 plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Right? 40 plus 60, 100 plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Angle C is equal to 180 minus 100 is equal to 80 degree. So, angle C is equal to 80 degree. In triangle PQR, angle P plus angle Q plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. Here, 40 plus 80 plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. 120 plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. Angle R is equal to 180 minus 120. Angle R is equal to 60 degree. So here angle R is 60 degree. Angle C is 80 degree. In triangle ABC, angles are 40 degree, 60 degree and 80 degree. Triangle PQR, angles are 40 degree, 80 degree and 60 degree. Here, these two triangles, one side and all angles of these two triangles are equal. Right? Here, the other two sides of these triangles are equal. Here, this side and two angles on its edge of triangle ABC is not equal to this side and two angles on its edge of triangle PQR. That is, the sides AC and PR are not equal. AC is not equal to PR. Similarly, the sides BC and QR also not equal. Is it clear, children? Next, see this quadrilateral ABCD. Here, the opposite sides ABCD and the opposite sides AD, BC are parallel, right? So, this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Draw the diagonal AC. Split this parallelogram into two triangles, right? Here, this side and two angles on its ends are equal. For that, consider the triangle ABC and triangle triangle, right? Here AC is equal to AC common side. Next, the parallels AB and CD cut by a third line AC make angle CAB and angle DCA. These angles are alternate angles. Alternate angles are equal. Is it clear, children? So here angle CAB is equal to angle DCA. Alternate angles parallels AB and CD cut by a third line AC make angles CAB and angle DCA. Next, the parallels AD and BC cut by a third line AC make angles DAC and angle ACB. These angles are also alternate angles. Alternate angles are equal, right? So here angle ACB is equal to angle DAC. Alternate angles parallels AD and BC cut by a third line AC make angles angle ACD and angle DAC, right? Here CAB and this
AB
opposite sides are equal. So here AB is equal to CD. Opposite sides are equal. Right? Next, this side and two angles on its ends are equal. For that, the parallels cut by a third line AC make angle CAB and angle DCA are alternate angles. Alternate angles are equal, right? So here, this is the triangle ABE. So here, angle EAB is equal to angle DCE. Alternate angles are equal. Clear, children? Similarly, AD BC is the parallel cut by third line BD, make angles ABE and angle CDE. These angles are alternate angles. Alternate angles are equal. Angle A, B, E is equal to angle C, D, E. Alternate angles. Alternate angles are equal. In triangle A, B, C, E and triangle C, D, E, the sides A, B and C, D are equal. Its ends are also equal. So this side opposite equal angles are also equal. That is, here E is the midpoint of both the diagonals. That is, AE is equal to CE and BE is equal to DE. That is, in any parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other. In any parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other. Clear, children? I hope you understood this session. Practice these nicely at home. We will see in the next class. Bye.